My business is called Arubia Vintage. I've been trading about 18 months now. I basically source vintage clothing and accessories for the women of Liverpool. I sell mainly sort of through Facebook, ASOS Marketplace. But I also organise my own fairs and do house parties as well. So I like to think of myself as sort of a personal shopper for all my customers, really. Well, I've been in retail management for about 4 years, worked in Topshop and Selfridges. And even though I loved fashion, clothing, I had no work-life balance. So I'd been selling on through eBay and did sort of one regular vintage fair a month. And just felt like it was something I could make a living out of, and I wanted to sort of take back control of my life. So financially I was in a position where I could do it, so I sort of took the plunge 18 months ago, knowing that I sort of had the skills sort of from that retail background, sort of hopefully set up my own business and make it a success. I think I just love the design, the quality, the fact that it's unique vintage rather than, I think, a lot of things sort of mass produced, and I like the fact that you can sort of create your own style through vintage clothing. I think what's unique about me is that with the vintage that I source, I do try and cater for everyone. I want women of all sizes to feel beautiful in what they wear, so I cater everything from sort of size 6 to 20. I do voluptuous vintage, which is sort of size 16 plus, and I really want women to feel beautiful and feel amazing and really dressed to suit their shapes, really. So I do quite a lot of styling within my sort of role as, owner of Arubia Vintage, and really try and buy for my customers specifically. So I do feel like I am sort of a personal shopper for all my sort of network of customers, really. I think I sort of naively thought, oh yeah, I'll just sort of set up my own business, it'll be fine, really easy. I've sold on eBay, but I hadn't really realised how much was involved. So I think the women's organisation really helped guide me through that process of all the background, writing your business plan, sort of the commercial side, setting up your business, they really helped me through that. And it was a great opportunity, I think, going to the workshops with other sort of female business owners and sharing those experiences and actually just having exposure to other people, because from going sort of a big management team within retail to trading on your own, it is quite a big change. So it really helps keep me focused and keep sort of that goal setting really realistic. But it was just invaluable for me, really. I think I couldn't have done it without that support, and knowing that you've done it sort of properly and established yourself is amazing and really empowers me, I think, to see that other women could achieve this and I could too. The business has really sort of taken off. Obviously, I said I've been trading 18 months. The first year was quite tough, so it was, establishing myself and building my customer base. But now I'd say the last 6 months, so from 12 months, it's really, really, I've got a really strong customer base. And I organise my own vintage fairs called the Little Vintage Fair. I've been doing that for 12 months, which are quite successful, quite local fairs, but sort of more intimate than some of the bigger ones that they run in Liverpool. I also am a voluptuous vintage stocked in a local boutique as well, which sells clothes for women size 16 plus, and that's something that I've found is a real big proportion of my market. It's a market that I hadn't really considered, but I'd probably say about 40% of my customers are probably size 16 plus now, so that was a real good opportunity. But I think turnover wise, I've exceeded last year's turnover already this year. So I think it's really, really growing, and I'm now in a better position financially than I was employed. So it's really nice to see that, my business has sort of grown and I can sort of sustain a living. And I think the feedback from customers as well, that they like what I'm doing and they love my stocks. That's, the best thing, really. I think it's just I've taken back that control. I've got freedom to, if I want to go on holiday or want to socialise, I've got that freedom to work around my life, and it's not dictating my life. And I think I'm just getting paid to shop, really, which is my dream. And I think I'm doing something I love. I'm passionate about my brand, sort of Arubia Vintage, and yeah, just never look back. Amazing. I think it's, the big thing is to believe in your brand and have passion for your brand. And that's something I've only maybe got in the last 6 months, and to really sort of feel that affinity with your own brand, and that will help drive it forward. I think utilise the startup support that is available, like through the women's organisation. It is invaluable to help guide you through that. Utilising sort of social media, that has been a big part of my business. It's obviously, free, but it's a great way to sort of reach, sort of make your business more national rather than just local, and then covering Europe, the rest of the world. And I think really networking and utilising the expertise of others, sharing experience. I think I've learnt a lot through others, and I've now found I'm in a position where I can help others as well through what I've learnt. So I think it is just talking to people and just increasing your network of business owners, really, to really sort of share that experience and celebrate success, really. So Arubia Vintage is on Facebook, so if you search for just Arubia Vintage, that's where I update all my new stock, and there's links to all the fairs, the little vintage fair which I run in Waterloo, Formby, Southport, and so that's really the hub of sort of my business. And if there is anything that people want me to source, I'm contactable via Facebook as well, so just get in touch.